In this video, I'm going to talk about types of keyword. In our previous video, as we covered what is keyword, so in this video, we are going to discuss different types of keywords here. Hello friends, I'm Shivani Goel. Welcome in WsCube Tech. So let's start with the sum of the type of keyword. Here we have targeting keywords, keyword by length, on-site keywords, Google Ads keyword, buyers keyword. So these are the some types of keyword here. Let's start discuss one by one what are these type and what are the forms we are learned in this particular types here. So first of all, we have targeting keywords. So as its name shows, targeting. Targeting means where you target any particular segment, where you target your customers, your product, any kind of brand, your competitor or your geo-targeted keywords. Okay, so these are the meaning of targeted here, that where we can target any particular market, customer, products. Okay, so let's start with the one of the segment known as market segment. Market, in case of market segment, we can find the keywords that are generic. Generic keywords that associate with any industry or any brand. Term, a target audience uses to search for general information within a vertical in which you can make your website in your vertical area. Any kind of term your audience are used to search for any kind of general information. The terms may be broadly associated with an industry or more defined for niche marketing purposes. Example, running shoes. This is a generic term here. Okay. Example, your sunglasses. This is also a generic term here. So in your particular niche, any kind of keyword which your audiences are targeting, you can use here. Next we have is the customer defining keyword. In case of customer defining, so as its name shows, that completely focus on customer here. Okay, so search phrases that identify a specific subset of customers or audiences. Okay, so customers use word or the phrase to define themselves. Example, running shoes for women. Here for women, women is what? This is your customer. And this type of keyword is known as customer defining keyword. Next we have product keyword. So as its name shows, product. Product means that where we define keyword for any particular product. The term related to specific brand offering. These are the phrases that directly reference a company's product or a services. Brands should have a keyword strategy for each of their product and services. So customers and prospectus can find their offering through searches. For example, your Netflix contract, and for our e-commerce marketing, we can also use this type of keyword, that is your product keyword. Okay. After your product keyword, now we have branded keyword. In case of branded, where the search phrase that include a brand's name. Here, our completely focus is on our brand name or other branded term. So they include only the brand name or the brand name along with the product name. Just like you can see here, Nike is your brand and running shoes is your product here. So by this way, you can say that for your branded keywords, we can focus on our brand name along with your product type, your product name or other descriptive search phrases. Next we have competitors keyword. In case of competitor, our target brand name of competing business, product or services here. Okay, it's beneficial for a brand to research competitor keyword because it gives brand an opportunity to attract a similar audiences of interested potential buyers. For example, for Nike, what's the competitor of Nike here? We have Reebok and the other brand of the shoes. These all are the competitors of Nike here. So for Nike, our competitor is Reebok. So the keyword, just like Reebok running shoes, this is the competitor keyword for this particular brand. Okay, now we have geo targeting. Here geo stands for geographical location. Okay, so geo-targeted keywords are the search phrases that identify a location that is based on location. For example, in your particular area, if you are searching for any particular information of your area, here you can mention the keyword in which your area name mentioned. Here, just example, you can see running shoes store Tampa, or you can also say running shoes store for Delhi, running shoes store in Mumbai. So what are these keywords? These are your geo-targeted keywords. So the searchers who use these terms are looking for the result that are near them or in other area they are interested. Let's suppose if the person of the Delhi is interested in the Mumbai product, so they can also mention Mumbai as in their keyword here. So this type of keyword is known as geo-targeted, where they can target for any specific area. Next we have keyword by length. So as we covered our targeting keyword here, after your targeting keyword, the next we have is the keyword by length. On the basis of length, we can determine keyword. We have three type of keyword on the basis of length, and that are your short tail keyword, which are also known as head, broad or generic keyword. Next we have mid tail keyword, which are longer than your short tail keyword and shorter than your long tail keyword. And next we have long tail keyword. So in case of your short tail keyword or your generic keyword, your head keyword, what are this keyword is? Your head keyword, which are also known as generic keyword, are popular broad search terms that have a very high volume of search traffic, because these are very common words. These are used by very common inquiry. If a person just want to get any information, so they can use a very generic term here. So that's why for these terms we have high search traffic, and also we have a lot of competition here. These terms are usually one or two words. Example, running shoes. This is just a generic keyword here. So they are very competitive to rank for. Next we have mid-tail keyword. That falls between your short-tail keyword and your long-tail keyword. Here we have mid-tail keyword. Okay? And which have a small volume of traffic but with less competition and higher conversion rate. Okay, so these terms are usually two or three words and are slightly more descriptive than your generic head term. Just example, if your generic term or your short term is your running shoes here. Okay, now we are added some suffix and prefix here, that is best running shoes or running shoes for women, running shoes for men. So these all are your mid-tail keyword, in which we have two to three words here. Okay. Next we have long-tail keywords. Long-tail keywords, as its name shows, that they are longest search term and are very targeted to a specific topic or audiences. So these terms typically have low search traffic and a low competition keyword, which make them easier to rank for. Because in case of long-tail keyword, here people target that they are interested in any particular product, and that's why they are just using long tail keyword just to get more information about that. Okay, because they are more specific, they are generally have high conversion rate than your head and the mid tail keyword. And for your long tail keywords, we also have low search volume and low competition here. Okay, for example, best running shoes for bad knees, best running shoes for women. Okay, for this type of keyword known as long tail keyword. Here you can see that the length of keyword can tell you a lot about its search volume, the potential traffic from it, and how well it could generate conversions here. So as you can see here that we have high search volume in the case of short tail here, but we have very low conversion rate, because these are very generic term here. For your mid tail, we have also high search volume and we have low conversion. But for your long tail, these are very specific keywords. So for this, we have a low search volume but having high conversion rate. So these are your keyword by length. Next we have on-site keyword. So as its name shows, on-site. On-site means the organic keyword which are used to rank your website organically. For your organic keyword, here we have two type of keyword here. One is your primary keyword, another one is your related or LSI keyword. LSI stands for latent semantic index keyword. Okay, in that, if I'm talking about your primary keyword, so these are the main term which you target on your web page. For example, if you want to design your website content or you are writing any particular blog, for this you have to decide one primary keyword here, and that primary term is a primary keyword here. That is the main term which are using in your particular content. That tells search engine that your particular content is about this particular topic. That tells the user, that tells the relevancy of the keyword to the user, that this particular term is related with your search query. So each pages of your SEO content should have one primary keyword assigned to it, which you can use in your title, meta description, content, body, URL, just to rank your website. For example, women's running shoes. This can be your primary keyword here. For targeting your primary keyword, we are not focusing keywords by length. We are just focusing one primary keyword here. Okay. Next, we have related keywords or latent semantic keywords. In case of latent semantic or related keywords, so as its name shows, these are related keywords. Related means, for example, if your primary keyword is women's running shoes, then related means running shoes reviews, women's running shoes sales, best women's running shoes. So these are related to your particular query. Like their meaning are same, but they are exploring more about that particular keyword. Okay, so related keywords are the term or the phrases that are semantically related to or variation or synonyms of a primary keyword. Okay, used to support a primary keyword in a piece of content. Each web page should be assigned one primary keyword and 3 to 4 related keywords that give additional context to the page. Okay, so these are related keywords here. Next we have Google Ads keyword. Google Ads means the keyword which you focus to create advertisement here. We have some type of keywords here, that is broad match, phrase match, exact match and negative match. On the basis of these keywords, you have to decide that your ad will showcase to which type of people who are entering broad match keyword or who are entering phrase match or who enter your exact match keyword. So in case of your broad match keyword, here the search term you target in the Google Ads search campaign, when a term is set as a broad match keyword, it tells Google to show your ad for any search that is a variation of the keyword. Variation of the keywords means, for example, if your keyword is shoes, if in any phrase or any particular keyword or any particular sentence, if you can find shoes in your query, in that case you can showcase my ad. So this information you can tell to Google with the help of this broad match keyword selection here. The ad will show if someone searched for a similar phrase, singular or plural form, misspelling, stimming, synonym or other relevant variation of the broad match term. Okay, for example, in ad for the broad match keywords, just like shoes. Next we have phrase match keyword. So as its name shows, that search phrase you target in a Google ad search campaign. So the search query may have the words that come before or after the phrase, but the exact phrase must be included in the search for it to show to searches. For example, in ad for the phrase match keywords, women shoes would show during searches for the terms such as women shoe sale, women shoe store and the stores of the women shoes. It means that which are slightly different, which are very slightly variation from your exact match keyword. Now we have exact match. Exact match means exactly the word we are using here. When a term is set at a exact match keyword, it tells Google to only show your ad if the search is extremely closely related to the exact match. For example, for your keyword women shoes, your ad will showcase if the keyword is women shoes, shoes women, or shoes for women, which are very closely related to the exact match keyword. Now, the next one we have is the negative keyword. Negative keyword here means, for example, if you use shoes for men, so this is your negative keyword. If someone searches shoes for man, then your ads will not reflect there. So this is the use of negative keywords here. Okay, after this, now we have buyer's keyword. This is the another form of keyword. In case of buyer's keyword, we have informational keywords. In case of informational, where user is searching for any particular information. In case of buyer's keyword, we are targeting our customer's interest, our customer's intent. What's their intent behind their particular keyword? They are looking for informational keyword. They are looking for navigational keyword. They are using your transactional keyword. So what type of the thing your user is adding here? In case of informational keyword, informational keywords are the term used search for when they want to find general information about a topic. So the searches use informational keyword when they are in the awareness phase of the chase funnel. For example, what's the best running shoes? This is just a generic keyword here where user asking for any particular information, any generic information. Next we have navigational keyword. So as its name shows, navigational. Navigational means when they want to visit a website for a specific brand. So navigational here means that they are in the consideration phase. Okay, so the searcher often use navigational keywords when they are in the consideration phase of the purchase funnel. Okay, for example, Nike running shoes. It means now they decide to purchase their shoes and they also decide to finalize their brand name, that is Nike. And now they want to purchase shoes from this particular brand. So they are in consideration phase. Next we have transactional keyword. In case of transactional keyword, these are the terms used when the searcher, they are already to make a purchase. Okay, so the searches use transactional keyword when they are in the conversion phase of the purchase funnel. In case of conversion phase, what type of query they are asking? Just like best deal on Nike running shoes. It means they exactly consider Nike running shoes here and now they already purchased that and now they just look at the best deal. They are on the final step of their purchasing. Okay, on the conversion phase, your user is and they are asking for the best deal here. So this type of keyword known as transactional keyword. So this is all about the different type of keywords here. In our next video, we will discuss a lot about keywords. So thank you so much for watching this video.